In this video, we're going to go over predation and the relationship between predators and prey. In these relationships, the predator species eats the prey species. These interactions are positive-negative interactions, as one gets a food source from the other, whilst the other dies or is harmed as a result of the interaction. An example of predation between animals is seen in the predator, the Canada lynx. The Canada lynx predates on mice, birds, squirrels, but also predates heavily on the snowshoe hare. Herbivory is the form of predation on plants. An example of this is the predation of swan plant leaves by the monarch butterfly caterpillar. Interactions between predator and prey have impacts on natural selection. Prey evolve traits that reduce predation. Predators evolve traits to get around any defenses of the prey. This is called a co-evolutionary or evolutionary arms race. An example of this is seen between bats, the predator, and moths, their prey. Both are nocturnal, so bats use echolocation to find and catch their prey in the dark. Moths have in turn evolved the ability to detect the echolocation used by hunting bats, and the ability to change their flight patterns to try and avoid the bat, and some have evolved the ability to make their own noises to confuse the hunting bat. Then in turn to these defense strategies, some bats have evolved strategies to change the frequencies of their echolocation click above or below the level the moths have evolved to detect to evade detection. Then the moths evolved the ability to detect these and in some cases also be able to discriminate between different levels of clicks to determine whether they are being hunted or just found by the bat to save energy on defensive maneuvers. The interaction between predator and prey also has an impact on the population sizes of both the predator and the prey, and create what are called predator-prey cycles. An example of this can be seen if we go back to our example of the predator, the Canada lynx, and specifically its preferred prey, the snowshoe hare. The interaction between these two species affects the population size of each. When the population of the predator, the Canada lynx, which is the red line, is low, the population of the prey, the snowshoe hare, which is the green line, grows as there is less predation. The increased population of prey increases the food supply for the predator, so the lynx population grows, but this in turn diminishes the food supply, so the snowshoe hare population declines. With less prey, the lynx population decreases again, and when low, the prey population grows again in a continuing cycle. Thank you for watching. If you want to support this channel, please subscribe and check out more of my videos.